The baby which lives inside the woman's womb is known as fetus, and it lives there for a total of 9 months and 7 days. A trimester means 3 months. So simple mathematics says that there are 3 trimesters in a pregnancy. The first 3 months or trimester equals to 13 weeks of gestation. Second trimester is from 13 to 27 weeks. And third trimester is from 28 weeks till the birth of the baby. In this video, I'll be talking about the importance of ultrasound in all trimesters of pregnancy. Welcome to Radio Clinics. With advances in science, ultrasound revolutionized medicine. It helps to pass sound into the fetus and visualize what is within. Baby inside the uterus is called embryo till 10 weeks of gestation. After 10 weeks, it is called fetus. In the early first trimester ultrasound, ultrasound examination helps in confirmation of pregnancy. Confirmation of pregnancy is usually done with the help of a pregnancy kit. Pregnancy kit helps in diagnosis of pregnancy, but it cannot determine whether the fetus is live or dead. By ultrasound, we can do confirmation of the pregnancy as well as we can confirm whether it is a live pregnancy or a missed abortion. Ultrasound also helps in determination of the location of the pregnancy. The fetus lives inside the uterus here, but sometimes the fetus may live outside the uterus, and in this case it is known as ectopic pregnancy. Location inside or outside the uterus is confirmed by ultrasound. If the fetus is lying outside the uterus, it is unlikely to survive and may cause life-threatening bleeding inside the woman, and it is one of the most deadly medical emergencies which may require immediate surgery. The exact age of the fetus can also be known by the ultrasound scan. This age of the fetus inside the womb is known as gestational age. This will help us to know the expected date of the childbirth, which is also known as expected date of delivery. At home, this is done mathematically by adding 9 months and 7 days to the last menstrual period. But this calculation does not always hold true. If the menstruation of the mother is irregular, or if the mother forgets the last date of her menstrual period, then the ultrasound done at 7 to 8 weeks or in the early first trimester will confirm the date of pregnancy and will also give a more precise estimation of the expected date of delivery. The age of the fetus will be accurately measured during the first trimester. In later pregnancy, age of the fetus will not be accurate by ultrasound, and there may be discrepancy up to 3 weeks in the third trimester. The first trimester ultrasound will also confirm whether it is a single pregnancy, or is it a twin pregnancy, or a triplet pregnancy. In this image, we can see twin pregnancy as visualized by the ultrasound scan. Late in the first trimester, at 11 to 13 weeks, we can look at the nasal bone and the nuchal translucency. Nasal bone means the bone of the nose. This is the bone of the nose. These scans are done to estimate the risk of Down syndrome in the baby. Down syndrome is the commonest chromosomal abnormality in the child, and with the syndrome there will be multiple defects in the child, like subnormal intelligence with IQ of 50 to 70, hearing defects, cardiac defects, abnormalities associated with kidneys and gastrointestinal tract. Down syndrome is associated with increased mother's age. And nuchal translucency scan, when combined with maternal blood test, will detect Down syndrome by 80 to 85% sensitivity. Absence of nasal bone also has association with risk of Down syndrome. The second trimester ultrasound. The main scan done at second trimester is the anomaly scan or the TIFFI scan, which is the targeted imaging for fetal anomalies. Anomaly scan is a comprehensive scan. It helps to detect gross congenital anomalies of the fetus. In this scan, detailed evaluation of the fetal body parts, including the brain, face, lips, lungs, heart, stomach, limb, kidneys are evaluated. The sensitivity of anomaly scan among various studies was found to be 70-80% for detection of congenital anomalies, and specificity was 99%. That means that if 100 fetuses have anomalies when born, it is likely that 70-80% of the anomalies will be detected and 20-30% will not be detected at the time of scan. Specificity is 99%, which means that if a baby is characterized as abnormal by ultrasound during 20-22 weeks, it is 99% likely that the born child will be abnormal, and only 1% likely that the child will be normal. In the third trimester, now the fetus is getting ready to born. So the different things that matter are on selecting the type of delivery and when the delivery of the baby should take place are taken into account. So the things that are important in this period are birth weight. Birth weight of babies of European heritage is 3.5 kgs on average, while in South Asian population it is 3.25 kgs on average. The birth weight of baby is notable because very low birth weight babies are 100 times more likely to die compared to normal birth weight babies. Growth of the baby and birth weight can be evaluated by the use of third trimester ultrasound. The fetus, which lies with its head down towards the cervix of the mother, is called the cephalic presentation. If the fetus lies with its head up, it is known as bridge presentation. Sometimes the baby lies horizontal, and this is known as the transverse lie. If the presentation is cephalic, the delivery is more likely to be from normal natural vaginal delivery. If the presentation is bridge or transverse lie, the delivery of the baby may require cesarean section. This information of presentation and lie of the fetus is also known by ultrasound. Amniotic fluid is the fluid that surrounds the fetus. This fluid is important because it is the source of nutrition to the fetus. If the fluid is low, this can cause increase in morbidity and death of the fetus. More amniotic fluid is also not favorable for the health of the fetus. We can estimate the amniotic fluid volume around the baby by ultrasound. Location of the placenta can also be done by ultrasound. Ultrasound can also show the health of placenta. If the placenta is lying too low, like in this case, it may block the baby from being born and it may cause deadly bleeding during delivery. This condition is known as placenta previa. In this condition, the fetus is delivered by cesarean section. Additional scans during pregnancy are done when clinically indicated. However, WHO guidelines has recommended that only one ultrasound scan before 24 weeks of gestation to estimate gestational age, improve detection of fetal anomalies, multiple pregnancies, reduce induction of labor for postpartum pregnancy, and improve women's pregnancy experience. WHO recommendation is a little different from what is recommended by obstetricians and gynecologists. Obstetricians and gynecologists recommend multiple scans during various trimesters of pregnancy. This is probably because WHO recommendation applies poorest of poor societies and where ultrasound machines are not readily available. So it recommends at least one scan to be done. Is there harm from repeated ultrasound? Ultrasound are almost always safe, but risks of thermal effects from Doppler study in the first trimester is theoretically shown, because Doppler study in utero gives rise to increased apoptosis in animal models. So it is better to avoid Doppler study in first trimester unless indicated. But normal B-mode ultrasound, which we usually do in normal scans, has not been shown to be harmful in different studies. What are the preparations before ultrasound? For first trimester ultrasound, full bladder is necessary. When the bladder is full, the urine in the bladder acts like a window to visualize the structures inside the uterus. For the second and third trimester ultrasound, full bladder is not necessary because the fetus will have grown significantly to be easily visualized. What is 3-dimensional and 4-dimensional ultrasound? 3-dimensional ultrasound means adding additional dimension so the face, spine and other organs may be easily visible. It will be easier to diagnose and to document certain conditions like cleft lip and spinal problems. 4-dimensional ultrasound is 3-dimensional ultrasound with added motion. When a lifelike image of fetus is seen by the parents, this may be entertaining and assuring to the parents, and it may also help in emotional bonding in between the parents and child. Can ultrasound predict the mode of delivery? This is another commonly asked question. A baby may be born either by vaginal route or by cesarean section. These modes of delivery are chosen by taking a close look at the health of the fetus, status of the child and mother at the time of delivery, other diseases in the mother and many other factors. For example, an emergency cesarean section may be carried out if the mother is having very high blood pressure and her blood pressure is threatening her or child's life. So ultrasound solely does not accurately predict the mode of delivery but may be of help. For example, conditions like complete placenta previa need delivery by cesarean section. If there is twin pregnancy which is diagnosed by ultrasound, the chances of cesarean section are high. If there is very low amniotic fluid volume, the obstetricians prepare for early induction of labor or cesarean section when required, and these all conditions can be diagnosed by ultrasound scan. Thank you.